Welcome to Lecture Online, and here to get a better sense of how we calculate and define the torque on a current loop, I've tried to illustrate this in various settings of what the current loop would look like at various points in its rotation around the center of axis. So let's say we have a plane right here, so this is the plane, and here we have a current loop that's rotating around about the center of the loop. Notice that the distance from there to there is b, the distance from there to there is a, small b, small a, so that the area of that loop, the cross-sectional area, would be a times b. Notice how it's rotating around the center like this. The b field is going through the plane, perpendicular to the plane, and so I've tried to illustrate that in five situations here, where the loop is parallel to the plane, then the loop turned at an angle of 45 degrees, now the loop is turned at an angle of 90 degrees, and it's turned over 135 degrees, and finally it made a half a turn at 180 degrees turn. So we're looking at a half a turn of the loop as it's looping through, and then we have the B field that's directed through the plane. The plane is indicated by the dashed lines right here. Notice the angle goes from 0 to 45 to 90 to 135 and to 180 degrees, and in each case we're going to calculate the torque on the loop in these various situations. Notice that we know that the torque is equal to R cross F, and that's of course taking one single force, it would be this distance R cross F, and of course when we calculate that, we did that in the previous video, we ended up with RF sine of theta, and then if we calculate it all on, we had the current times the cross-section area times the B field times the sine of the angle where the loop is situated. Notice the two here come from the fact that there's two forces, one pulling in this direction and one pulling in this direction, so that they have to be added together. Now, what would be the torque in this case? Well, here we would get the torque. Oop, and I better get a different color. So here we have the torque is equal to IAB times the sine of 0 degrees. Oop, I should say 0 there. 0 degrees, and of course sine of 0, 0, that means there's zero torque at that point, which makes sense when we have the two forces. And just as a repeat here, notice that we're looking at the loop from the side here, so notice that the current is going into the wire in this direction, comes out of the wire in this direction, so that's indicated here. Cross means into the board, out of the board. And for practice, let's say that we use our right hand rule, point the fingers in the direction of the B of the current, then turn your fingers around and turn them in the direction of the B field straight up, and then the force will be to the right. So we have a force that's to the right here, let's call it F1, and over here we have the current coming out this way, B field is up, force is to the left, so we see a force F2 to the left. And notice that the distance, the perpendicular distance from the point of rotation to the line of action of the force is 0. That means there's zero torque, and that's how we get 0 right there. All right, over there you can see that the current is into the board, B field is up, force is to the outside, so we have a force in this direction. Oop, that would be force 1, not force 2. And then over here we have the current coming out, B field up, force to the left, so this is F2. And here you can see that there is indeed going to be a torque. The torque is going to be, let's see here, it's going to be in a clockwise direction. We use a different color. So here that causes a torque in that direction. So if you curl your fingers in the direction of the motion that the forces would cause the loop to move in. Now notice, I had the loop moving in this direction, but the torque causes a force trying to make it move in the opposite direction. And of course, the direction of the torque would be into the board. And that's how we indicate that. It's a clockwise direction. So the torque is turned into the board. And what is the magnitude of that torque? Well, we can say here that the torque is equal to IAB times the sine of 45 degrees, which is 0.707, so this is equal to 0.707 IAB. That would be the magnitude of that torque. Looking at it over here, by now you can see that the force would be in this direction, and the force here would be in this direction. Opposite direction like that. Notice at this point we have the maximum torque. You see that you have the maximum distance between the point of rotation and where the wires can be. So this here is the maximum perpendicular distance from the point of rotation to the line of action of the force. Maximum torque. Therefore, we know that the torque here is equal to IAB times the sine of 90 degrees, which is 1, which is simply IAB. And of course, that will then be the maximum torque that we can have at any point in time. Again, the direction of the torque would be clockwise. So the torque would be clockwise, which means it would be pointing into the board. All right, coming over here, you can see that the force here would be in this direction, F1, and the force here would be in this direction, F2. Notice that it would still try to rotate the loop in this direction, even though the loop is rotating this way, the torque would be in the opposite direction. And so we have a torque in this direction. Put your fingers in the direction of that motion, thumb into the board, and the magnitude of the torque. Torque is equal to IAB times the sine of 135 degrees. Of course, that's 0.707, which is 0.707 times IAB. And finally, when we look at the case where the loop is now turned to a half a turn, 180 degrees, notice that over here, the current is into the board, the B field is up, so the force is in this direction. That would be F1. And over here, the current is out of the board. B field is up. Force is in this direction. That's force 2. Notice there's no perpendicular distance from the point of rotation to the line of action of the force because the line of action of the force goes right through the point of rotation. Therefore, zero torque. We can see that visually here. And we can say that the torque is equal to IAB times the sine of 180 degrees. Which is equal to zero, so therefore the torque is equal to zero in this final case. So here you can say torque is equal to zero, 0.707 IAB, maximum torque, 0.707 IAB, zero torque. I wonder what would happen when it turns one more turn, another 45 degrees. Well, let's take a quick look and see what would happen. So if now it turns to an angle of 225 degrees, then we'd say that the torque is equal to IAB times the sine of 225 degrees, which is now a minus 0.707. So now we have a negative torque. Well, let's see if that makes sense. So this would be equal to minus 0.707 times IAB. Remember, I is the current, B is the magnetic field, A is the cross-sectional area. And so the question now is, will that give us a negative torque? Well, let's see here. Notice that the section of the loop that is now over here that has a current going into the board, and here we have the current going out of the board. We have the B field coming straight up, right? The B field is going perpendicular to the plane, and the force over here would be in this direction. And the force over there would be in this direction, so that would be F1. This would be F2. And notice in this case, the torque would now be directed in the opposite direction. It would be counterclockwise. So now we have a torque in this direction, and that would, of course, now you can see that the torque is in the opposite direction. So now we have the torque coming out of the board, so therefore we have a negative value for the torque. Now you say, well, wait a minute, isn't torque positive when it's out of the board and negative when it's into the board? That is true, except in this case I have my reference angle, the angle to be between the plane and the section of the loop. If we had taken the reference angle to be between the perpendicular to the loop and direction of the B field, then we would have gotten a different angle and then the sines would have been reversed. So it all depends upon where you set your reference angle. So I will show you one more example in the next video where I'll take a different reference angle once we have the magnetic moment figured out correctly, and then you can see that it really doesn't matter if you use this reference angle or the other reference angle. The essence is still correct, that you'll get the correct direction of the torque. That's how we do that.